What's up? George Edmondson here with MotionVFX.com. Today we're going to be looking at the brand new plugin mKBHD. Now mKBHD comes packed with over 50 presets that are designed to help you streamline your editing process and utilize some of the same sets of tools that the mKBHD team uses on their videos. Now obviously these are mKBHD branded, but you can get in there and customize those how you see fit, and I'm going to show you how to do it right now in Final Cut Pro.
To install mKBHD, simply go into mInstaller and select the mKBHD plugin for your NLE of choice. We have it here for Final Cut Pro, DaVinci Resolve, and Adobe Premiere Pro. In this tutorial, we are going over Final Cut Pro, so let's click to install. And we can see here it is now installed, so let's jump over to Final Cut Pro for the tutorial. In Final Cut Pro, mKBHD can be found in your titles as well as your transitions. mKBHD comes with over 50 different presets, and some of these presets include backgrounds, calls to action, features, intros, lower thirds, titles, and tools and effects. And then we have 6 transitions. So since we are starting out, why don't we go ahead and begin with one of our intros? You apply these just like any other titles. You can click and drag into your timeline. So why don't we just pick up intro number 3, and we're going to click that and drag this into our primary timeline here in Final Cut Pro. As we scroll down, we can see all of the goodness happening. So let's click our title and let's open up our inspector. Now, as with all MotionVFX plugins, we have our awesome on-screen controls. These are used for position, scale, and rotation. And then we can go over to our inspector. We have our animations in, out, and through. And then we can make adjustments to our position, scale, and rotation there in the inspector. As we come down, you can see intro type. Here we have selected logo, but you can change that to text, and that is going to be in your first title there if you want text instead of your drop zone, or you can simply select none if you don't want anything there, and you can use one of the other titles as part of your intro. For this, we're just going to select logo. And then as we scroll down, we can see here that we have our logo, drop zone, and there is no source. So we're going to open up our library sidebar here. And as we come down, we can see we have the mKBHD black logo there. So let's go back over into our inspector. We can click our drop zone well and come over and select the logo. And then we can click apply clip. Now we want to make some more adjustments to this, so why don't we bring the size of our logo down just a bit, and then if we wanted to change any of the position of that, we can do so here in our inspector. Now as we scroll down, we have all of our information for our first title if you wanted to make changes there, and then we have our secondary title. If we wanted to make changes here, we just simply click into our title box and make changes. Continue to scroll down, and we can even fine-tune all of our elements. So if you wanted your arrow on or off, and then you can make adjustments to the color as well as position, rotation, scale, etc. through those parameters. And then finally, we have our grain. You can toggle your grain on and off if you would like, as well as make changes, and then your background. Now, I am gonna change this background color since it's kind of hard to see our logo that we've selected. So I'm gonna do that by clicking on this color wheel, and let's just simply slide up and we can make this white or even kind of a darker gray there. All right, cool. And then I think that I might want to be able to see my crosses a little bit better as well. So why don't we come back up and you can see we've got our crosses color. We can just simply click that, and I'm going to use my eyedropper tool and I'm going to select the color of our logo. That way everything is cohesive and looks good together. So now we're going to show you some of our backgrounds. Let's just pick up background number 3. We can drag that into our primary timeline as well. and let's go in and you can kind of see what's going on here. So our background comes in with those classic MKBHD arrows. Let's go over into our parameters here. So we have our animation in and out in our inspector. We have our main color one, our main color two that you can modify. We have our grain, again, that you can toggle on and off, as well as make changes to the grain amount, type, etc. And then we have our glow. So let's toggle that on and off so you can see what's going on there. Glow, and you can make changes to those parameters. And then our background, which again, you can just click and you can make changes to your background as you see fit. So backgrounds are great because you can use any of these other sorts of titles, call to actions, features, etc. over these. And in this one, we are going to just show you one of the titles. So let's scroll down and you see we have five different titles here. So we've got title number one. You can see that there. Title number two comes in, which I like that one a lot. Title number three has a drop zone. We've got title number four and title number five. So with this one, I think I just want to use title number one. So I'm just going to click and drag that in over top of our background here. And then you can see everything is going to animate in together pretty beautifully there. So I want that to animate in actually a little bit after our arrows. So you see I've got our arrows have come down. So I'm just going to click the handle on title number one and trim that a bit. So now we have our animation in from our background and then our title comes in. So let's click on our title. Again, we have our on-screen controls for position, scale, and rotation. And then over in our inspector, we have our animations in and out, all of our position, scale, and rotation parameters, text number one that you can make changes in the text box here really quickly. And then if you need to make any changes to that text, such as font, size, alignment, etc., you do there. And then our text number two. And again, all of your options here. Now we have our crosses. If you want to toggle those on and off, you can make changes, of course, to any of those for spread, opacity, rotation, color, etc. You can really fine tune this. And then we have our signet. So here's a global that we can turn on and off, but then we can also toggle on parts one and parts two, make changes to color, etc. And then of course our glow and drop shadow. If you are placing this on a white background or a lighter background and you want a drop shadow, that is a global drop shadow that's going to be over the entire title. All right, great. So let's move on down and we can see how we can place some of these over some footage. So here we have Marquez on screen, and let's say that you do not know who that is and we want to use a lower third. So let's just scroll back up and you can see we have our different lower thirds. I can give you a quick preview of some of those. Really cool. You just simply hover and scroll over those and you can see how those look. So for this one, I think that I want to maybe use one of the lower thirds that comes in on the left side since we've got more of an empty frame here. So why don't we just pick up lower third number one. I like number one over this. So we're going to bring that in and let's push down and then we can see. Here we go. Now, of course, this is not Jesse Goldman, so we need to change that. So, of course, this is MKBHD himself, Marquez Brownlee. So there we go. And then we can scroll down and we can say he, of course, is a video expert, but why don't we just change his title to... Cool. So again, with these titles, you've got your on-screen controls for position, scale, rotation. And then we've got all of those options here in our inspector as well, where you can change those really quickly. Those look great. If you want to turn on your V shapes, turn those on and off, you can do so here, as well as your crosses. And again, noise, glow, and drop shadow options. So that was our lower third. So why don't we now scroll down and we can talk about our features. So let's go back over into our title browser and let's find our features. There they are. So we have five different features. Let me hover over those so you can get a quick preview. There we go. So we are going to show maybe some of the features of this flip phone that Marquez is reviewing. So why don't we just pick up feature number four and let's drag that in over top of this phone. As we push down, you can see we've got a couple of on-screen controls here. So let's talk about that. We have our on-screen controls once again for position, scale, and rotation. Now I'm going to leave that over here to the left because I want to not, you know, go over top of the phone. Then we have this other on-screen control. Now that is just simply adjusting the spacing of these different elements beneath. So that is the only purpose and use for that on-screen control. As a matter of fact, you can only move that up and down on the Y-axis. All right, over in our inspector, animations in and out. All of our content, position, scale, rotation, and then we have our points. So we can modify this up to 10 points, which is pretty awesome. So if you're reviewing a lot of stuff, that's where this comes in handy for your spacing. Let me change that back. Let's just go to 3 points here. We've got our different description positions, our ratings scale. So that is going to just make changes to those elements there for your ratings. Then our rating color, rating background, and rating background color. And then you get to make changes to your title here. So we're evaluating that phone, so we can just leave that set. And then all of your different descriptions. Now I'm going to scroll really quickly to show you. You have descriptions for all 10, even if they're not all showing up. So just be mindful of that, that if you have, for instance, selected 3, then you only need to deal with the 3 descriptions here and you can leave the rest blank. All right, so let's say that the performance of this phone is just fantastic. It's through the roof. Well, we know that in our description 1, there's our performance. So the way that you adjust the rating is here right below your description. So let's just change that to 5. But let's say it's not very easy to use. It's an awesome phone as far as performance, but the ease of use is not very easy. So we're going to give that a 2. So let's just say that it is ridiculously expensive. So we're going to change that to 1 because this phone costs $1 million. It doesn't really. You actually need to go and check out MKBHD's review on this and you can learn more. All right, so we have just gone over features. Next, we want to talk a bit about the tools. All right, so why don't we go back over to our titles and let's scroll all the way down to the bottom to tools and effects. Now you've got a lot of tools and effects here and we don't have time to go over all of them, but if you've seen any MKBHD video, you will recognize these pretty quickly. So let's say that we want to do a bit of a punch in on both our feature, our evaluations feature, and the phone itself. So why don't we come down to our zoom in? These are working as adjustment layers. So we're going to click that title over top of our feature as well as our clip. And you can already see that something is starting to happen here. So we've got that quick zoom in going on. Highlight your title and you have these fancy on-screen controls, and this is how you can position things as well as scale them. So we just want that little bit of punch in to show that we're talking about this and he, you know, maybe wants you to see this evaluation. So here we go over in our inspector, animation in and out. Then we have our animation in type. We have regular, so instant would be more of a jump cut. Quick is what it sounds like. It's just a really quick zoom in. Regular is just a sort of regular strength right there in the middle. And then smooth is a bit of a slower push in. We're going to leave that at regular. You can make changes to your position and scale in your inspector if you want to. However, I prefer the on-screen controls. And then we have our zoom sharpen. And if you toggle that on, it's just going to give a little bit of sharpness over everything, because sometimes you will tend to lose that sharpness if you're not shooting in glorious 8K. So let's see how that is looking. Now, that is just one of the tools and effects, but listen, there is a lot to unpack here with tools and effects, so I really encourage you, if you pick this plugin up, to spend a lot of time with these, because there's a lot that you can do here. For instance, even the things like adding a thumbnail creator is really, really cool and very important, as you all know, in the world of YouTube. So having that thumbnail creator here is a really good touch from the MotionVFX team. All right, so we still have our calls to action and our transitions. So why don't we find one more clip? Let's find Marquez here. I'm going to tap I and O. We're going to drop that into our timeline, clicking E. And then we're going to say that this here is our final clip, and we're going to add that call to action. I'm also going to set my spatial conform to fill just for the purposes of this tutorial. Let's go back into our title, and we've got our calls to action here. So I'm going to pick up call to action number 2, drag this in on top of our clip. Let's go ahead and reposition that so that it is over top of just mKBHD, Marquez there. Highlight our title. And again, we have our famous on-screen controls for position, scale, and rotation. That's global. And then we have our secondary on-screen controls. And this is just for spacing of each of these separately. Over in our inspector, we have animations in and out, our position, scale, and rotation. We have our bars amount. So if you only wanted to show maybe YouTube and Instagram, you can select that and it is going to automatically reposition to the center for you, which is really nice. And then in our text, you can make changes to the text here in your text box. And if you want to change your icon, you can do so as well, depending on what text you are adding. Or you can select a custom icon and you can fill your drop zone with your custom icon or logo. And finally, let's say you want to transition out of your video. You apply your transitions by coming over. You can hover over each to see which one you like the best. I really enjoy transition number 2. So we're just going to click that, drag it in on top of our clip. I'm going to bring my call to action back just a little bit so they'll animate out together. And then as you can see, our animation starts to happen with our call to action and goodbye, Marquez. See you on the next video. Again, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Thank you for checking out this quick tutorial on the mKBHD plugin, now available for Final Cut Pro, Adobe Premiere, and DaVinci Resolve. Be sure to subscribe and we'll see you on the next one.